Dear brother and sister in Jesus Christ, today, 13 November, Catholic Church celebrates the memory of Saint Nicholas the Great. We don't know when he was born, but we know that, however, he lived in the 9th century AD. He belonged to a very good family, and in fact, his father, Theodorus, tried to give him a very good education. He studied literature, and he was so clever that when he was very young, he could enter, by the way, into the pontifical court that at the time was not only an important institution for Christianity, but was also a very important cultural institution in the Europe of the time. He had a very good relationship with Pope Benedict III, and in fact, every time Benedict III had a problem, he always spoke with Nicholas, and he considered him like a member of his family. In fact, when he died, Benedict III died, it was the 858, his successor, by the way, was Nicholas. Nicholas did not reign a lot as a pope, by the way, was pope only for 10 years, more or less. But however, he was a very clever pope, a very good pope, because at the time, the church was quite a weak institution in the Europe of the time. Europe of the time was quite a complex reality. There were not strong political institutions, and also the church was quite weak. There were contrasts between the western part of Christianity and the eastern part of Christianity. And so Nicholas, who had a very deep faith, tried in all the way to unify Christianity. For example, he fought against Photius, who was actually the Patriarch of Constantinople. And in particular, he was the first one who supported the ideas of universal church. That means that he was the first one who believed that church should have been an institution that should dominate, at least spiritually, upon all the other political institutions existing. It is important to point out that his faith was very, very sincere. In fact, around 861, he fought against John, who was the bishop of Ravenna. John made many abuses against local communities, against local bishops and priests who support the Pope, while instead he wanted to get a wider space from the Pope. He wanted to get more independence. And he also was excommunicated by the Pope, and this is very useful in order to understand how deep was his action at the time, considering that at the time, as I told you, the pontifical institution was quite weak. He was well known all around the Europe, and he died, by the way, in 867, following to the news we have, and he was buried, by the way, in St. Peter Church in Rome. So, behalf Saint Fend Association, I want to wish you a happy feast of Saint Nicholas.